what we have here is about a month and a half worth of work. And we got our, where we put our different hammer handles. Right there's our 200-pound melting pot. And our TIG cooler. Up underneath there is all the stainless steel and electrical lines. It runs everything there. Down inside of there is a thermostat that goes up to 700 degrees. And we've got that thing to turn the water on and off when these molds get hot. The stainless steel water jackets with funnels on them. And then right down in there we have the flow meters that shows you when the water is actually flowing through the molds. Little balls in there spin. Got our little air valve there with our flow control. So open and closing the molds on air cylinders there. And that's about it.
Do this again here, these babies. They'll start kicking in here. I usually like to pour the 5-pounder first because it's got the most material. Right there, there's enough for a 2. By the time that you get to your last one, 5-pounder's ready to open again. Gotta wiggle those bad boys out of there. And we got the 4-pounder. You see right there, the 4- and 5-pound water's just kicked on. And means the molds are getting up to temperature where they're gonna start running good.
Okay.
pour them too fast, you get nothing but rejects. You gotta take your time on the pour. It seems to be pretty critical to making good hammers. Thermostats kicked in. We got the flow meters rolling, showing you that the mold's cooling itself down. Go ahead and come in here and pop that baby out. Pop it down. Make up another 5 pounder there just to see what we got going. Based on what I used to do without water-cooled molds, this thing will set up pretty darn quick, as you'll see here. We'll be opening that 5 pounder here pretty shortly. It doesn't take long for that thing to cool down at all. Actually, it's ready right now. Gotta shrink it down a little bit. There you go.